Hi, this is John from Monster Craftsman. We wanted to just show you our newest product. It's a simple little thing. It's a fuel sight gauge. This product is superior to everything else that's on the market because we actually fabricate our own fittings that you weld on to the tank where you want them, and then there's no possible chance of leaking. It's ultra low profile. There's no hose clamps. We have some real clean clamps here, and it just works better, looks better, and you know, for about the same price, it's definitely what you want. No offense to my friends who make the other kits, but we like these ones, obviously, and we think you will too. So we're just gonna do an install video just to show you how easy it is to put one of these on a tank. Now the first thing we want to do before we drill any holes is figure out where roughly we want the actual sight gauge to go. And you can just mock it up and say, okay, I want it definitely start at the bottom of the tank, go up to the top, because that actually makes the function of the gauge work. Now this tube is 9 1/4 long, and if I don't want to put the fitting on the tube, because the way that we make these, just once you put them on, they're almost impossible to get off. They'll seal by themselves, and then with the addition of the clamp, you're sure that nothing will leak. But if I just kind of mock up how far the tube will go onto the fitting, let's say about 3/4 inch to be safe, I would measure from the end of the tube to the center of where the hole would be drilled on the tank, and that's another 3/4 inch. So what I would do then is take 9 1/4, and I would add 3/4 inch on each side, and that would be my rough measurement of where I want to put my two dots for my starter holes. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and I put a dot here, but this is where I want the bottom one to be. So that would be my start. And then I'm gonna actually measure the distance of the tube plus the 3/4 inch on each side, which is how far the actual final measurement will be. And I just want to kind of measure that up in a straight line. It's hard to do with a tape measure, but the measurement would be 10 3/4. So right about there. My second dot. And then you want to actually try to check. About 10 3/4. And what you want to do is basically you want to do two pilot holes in your tank. I would say an 1/8 inch drill bit that's sharp would do the job. Now when you get ready to drill your tank, I would actually obviously put it on something soft like a piece of cardboard or soft cloth, because as you're rolling the tank around on the table, you don't want to be denting it or scratching it. But now that I have my two holes, now you can center punch if you want, that's always the best thing, but if you have a sharp drill bit, you can get away with just drilling it in. Of course, the key word there is sharp. There's our two pilot holes. And I'm gonna open it up with like a 3/16 bit. Super easy. And then I'm gonna open it up with a step bit. And the hole on the fitting is only about 1/4 inch, so you don't have to get too crazy. I wouldn't go more than, let's say, 3/8 inch hole overall. That should be plenty. Okay. So now we have our holes in the tank, and when you go ahead and put your fittings on, you know, you want to match the center of the hole in the fitting with the hole in your tank. If you're put it up like this, basically what we're looking at. Now, after you drill your holes, before we actually start tacking the fittings on, it's a good idea to draw a line with a Sharpie or something like that, with a ruler or a piece of paper, just so you know which direction, you know, pretty precisely to face your fittings when you're gonna tack them on. That way, it kind of gives you the travel of your fuel sight gauge, and it lines everything up, helps you see the way it needs to go on, because the tank is curved, so if you put it on wrong, you're not going to be able to fix it unless you grind it off, so take the time now to get it right. Now that we have our straight line to show us where, what direction to put our fittings, you can basically put your fitting on and line it up with the line. Shoot it across with your eye, make sure it's going in a straight line on that Sharpie mark. I just put a shim there, just to shim it up. We're going to throw a tack. You obviously want to line the hole and fitting up with the hole in your tank. Now we have everything lined up and we're ready to put a tack on it. We are going to be welding these fittings on with a TIG welder today, running at about 98 amps. Really got to be careful with the thin gauge on the tank, and you want to try to focus your heat into the fitting rather than the tank. You can MIG weld this if you want it to look really awesome. That's a joke, but it can be done, and you can just finish grind it. And if you're putting a heavy coat of paint on the tank, because the fittings are so low profile anyways, it'll look really good. So we're gonna go ahead and put a tack on here and get started finalizing this project. Okay, we got a nice little tack on there, and basically can put a tack on the other side now. Alright, we got two tacks on it now, so I'm going to go ahead and do a weld all the way around it. Alright, I have my first fitting completely welded, so I'm going to line up my second fitting with the black line and go ahead and tack that and weld that also. The first fitting took me about 4 minutes to weld. You need to have someone who knows what they're doing with the TIG, and if you don't know anyone and you don't want to try it, we're happy to sell you a tank with the fittings already welded in it, available at monstercraftsman.com. One little tip I wanted to mention as far as TIG welding goes is because it's so thin, the material that the tank is made out of, it's nice to weld about 3/8 of an inch of weld and then stop and let the argon flow over your weld, let it completely cool, and then start back up, which that will minimize warping, and if you have a really paper thin tank, you won't be able to weld without doing that. Now, what makes these fittings better than anything else that's out there is once they're welded on the tank, assuming that your TIG welder knows what they're doing, there is no possible chance of them leaking, because with the other fittings you have to tighten up the pipe fitting And then expect that it'll line up perfectly and not leak. But if something happens and you have to tighten it more and actually tighten the fitting more, it changes your whole line with your fuel gauge. So this is a really, really good solution to that problem, and just works. We finished welding up the fittings. It came out great. It took about 10 minutes. And it's a really nice, clean option for your gas tank. So check them out at MonsterCraftsman.com.